Hey guys, welcome back. I'm Nick. This week's project is kind of a fun one. A nice little end table. Or a sofa table. Or a side table. You know what? Frankly, I don't care what you call the table. You can call it gym. But it's a nice fun little project to make. Doesn't take long at all. And it only takes two tools to make. I'll show you how I did it. Stick around. In the efforts of me trying to get this down to a two-tool project, lumber selection was kind of critical. I wanted to start out with 2x2 first stripping, but a lot of these are just warped and they just really wouldn't make good table legs. So I opted to spend a little extra here and go with select pine boards, 2x2 by 8 foot long. The 8 foot piece will yield me all four of my legs. To keep this to a two-tool project, I actually had my home center cut all the materials to length. There's no ripping needed in this project. My particular store will cut as many cuts as I need, essentially. Some places will charge, say, 25 or 50 cents a cut after so many cuts. You'll have to check with your store for details. If for whatever reason you're getting your materials at a location that they won't do any of the cutting for you, you can still do that with a handsaw and it'd still be relatively cheap. Or if you have access to a circular saw or a miter saw, will work as well. If you have the tools at your disposal, there's no reason you shouldn't use them. And yes, I actually did handsaw one of the cuts. And here's what the parts and pieces should look like. I'll have a full cut list and plans available on my website, nickferry.com. I could then get out my pocket hole jig and get started on the top. Basically, for the top, I wanted four pocket holes to secure the two boards together. You're going to want to play around with whatever your best faces are to these particular boards and what edges line up and hide the seam the best. Then I could just proceed to drill the pocket holes in the top. I could then move on to my table apron pieces, putting two pocket holes on each end of every board. It was at this point that I put a couple additional pocket holes in each of the apron pieces to secure the top later. After all that was said and done, it was time to start assembly. I lined up the two edges of my top and secured it with four pocket hole screws, giving me essentially a wider top. I started by attaching the first couple legs to the apron pieces using a 1/4 inch piece of MDF scrap as a spacer to offset the apron from the table leg. When I started doing this, I just held the pieces in place. If you're trying to do this as a limited tool project, this is definitely doable. But if you have a clamp available to you, I think this one cost right around $3. I would go ahead and use that because it makes aligning the pieces that much easier. Attach two of the legs to one of the aprons using four pocket hole screws, set that assembly aside, and repeat with another one. Once you got those two assemblies done, you can flip those on to the underside of the top, put in the other apron pieces, and secure those with screws as well. Once again, here a clamp isn't necessarily needed, but it does make it a heck of a lot easier. At this point, if you want, you could measure out to make sure that the top is nice and centered and secure it with some pocket hole screws. However, I wanted to do kind of a two-tone finish, so I didn't secure the top at this point. Again, not entirely necessary, but I took some time to take a card scraper to smooth out the seam in the top. Also, a little hand sanding with my orbit sander, or just even some hand sanding. I also took some time to take some sandpaper and break some of the sharp edges on the base. Then it was time for finish. I decided for the top I was going to use a dark walnut Danish oil. I basically flooded the surface and moved the Danish oil all around, and yeah, gave it about maybe 10 minutes or so to soak in, then came back and just wiped away any excess. For the base, I just decided to go with a nice white. Once I had the base completely painted, I could then secure it to the top. I just put down a terry cloth towel to eliminate scratching on the top, flipped it upside down, and put the base on as well, and secured it with a couple more screws. The top is going to expand and contract slightly. To combat this, I typically put pocket hole screws right where the seam of the two boards are. One on either side should be fine. We're not going to have an elephant be standing on this thing. Well, there you go. That didn't turn out too bad at all. In fact, I'm extremely pleased on how it ended up looking. Now, granted, if you don't like the character that knots bring to the table, you could use select pine for that as well. I just wanted to overall illustrate that if you've ever wanted to get into woodworking and you don't even so much as own a screwdriver, for about $15 worth of materials and a cheapo $20 cordless drill, and I think that smaller Kreg jig I used was about 20 bucks, you can get into woodworking and it's not necessarily gonna break the bank. And keep in mind, you own those tools afterwards, and well, then you could build the next table to match this one. Because that's something to remember. I've been into woodworking for 20 years and I don't think I've ever seen a single woodworker go out and buy everything they'll ever need in one fell swoop and spend thousands of dollars. It just doesn't happen that way. So if you do want to get into woodworking, I think this would be an awesome project to start with. So I appreciate you guys watching, and if you like projects like this and you haven't already subscribed, I encourage you to hit that subscribe button, and hopefully I'll see you next week. Or if you are into woodworking and you got a table saw or a bandsaw, there's no reason you can't make these 2x4s out of legs in the table versus legs out of 2x4s.